Quantum entanglement is the status of two subatomic particles which are somehow correlated with each other. The two entangled particles are maintaining an invisible quantum communication link between them. If a particular thing happened to one particle, then it affects a particular property of the other particles instantaneously. It is happening even both are separated by greater distance.
Subatomic particles are electron, proton, neutron in atom, and photons in the light. Electron has the property of spin, which refers to the direction pointing to its rotation. It may be up, down, left, right, or any other directions. Photon has the property of polarization, which refers to the pulsing direction of electromagnetic wave. Photon is a small chunk of energy wave. The direction of the wave may be horizontal, vertical, diagonal right, diagonal left, or any other directions. We cannot find the electron's spin direction by simply looking at it. It is not visible. It can be identified by its behavior under Stern-Gerlach apparatus. Stern-Gerlach device, which has non-uniform magnetic fields inside. Suppose an electron is passing through this device. While coming out, the electron deflected upward or downward based on its spin direction. If it is deflected upward, then we can conclude that it is spin up particle. If it is deflected downward, then we can conclude that it is spin down particle. Suppose the spin direction is neither up nor down, but right. Now, in which direction will it be deflected? In 50% of the time, it is going up, and another 50% of the time, it is going down. That means, if you measure it again and again 1000 times, then roughly 500 times it's going upward, and another 500 times it's going downward. After the measurement, the spin orientation is also changed according to its moving direction. Suppose it is going up. Here onwards, its spin orientation always will be 0 degree. If it is going down, then its spin orientation always will be 180 degree. The outcome is pure probability, which depends on the angle between particle spin and the orientation of the measuring device. What is the chance to going up when the spin is 0 degree to the measuring orientation? That is 100%. Yes. 100% of the time, it will be going up, and 0% of the time, it will be going down. If it is 90 degree, then the chances are 50-50. If it is 180 degree, then here is no chance to going up. 100% of the time, it will be going down. What is the chance to going up if it is 45 degree? That is not 75%, but 85%. If it is 135 degree, then the chances of going up is 15% and going down is 85%. We can understand it by projecting the spin point location to the measuring orientation. The same spin projection rule is applicable to the measurement of multiple particles in particular time period. Suppose 1000 spin rate electrons are passing through this device. The quantum probability chooses 500 electrons to upward and 500 electrons to downward. When we measure 8 particles which are 90 degree oriented, we can see 4 particles are going upward and 4 particles are going downward because the chances are 50-50. If we measure 20 particles which are 45 degree oriented, we can see 17 particles are going upward and 3 particles are going downward. If it is 135 degree, then 3 particles are going upward and 17 particles are going downward. Photon polarization can be measured by linear polarization filter. When we let a photon passing through a linear polarization filter, the photon may or may not pass. The passing chances are based on the angle between photon polarization and the filter orientation. If both are same, then the photon will pass for sure. If both are opposite, then the photon will not pass and absorbed by the filter. this photon polarization is 0 degree and the filter orientation is also 0 degree. So the photon passes the filter. This photon polarization is 90 degree, but the filter orientation is 0 degree. So the photon does not pass the filter. Photon is 0 degree, but the filter is 90 degree. So it is not passing the filter. If the angle between them is 45 degree, then quantum probability starts playing game here. The passing chances are 50-50. The photon's polarization will be changed and equal to the filter orientation if it passes in 50% of the time. Malus law determines the probability. Measuring multiple photons also has the same policy. If we measure 20 photons which are 45 degree oriented, then 10 photons are passing because the probability is 0.5. If we measure 20 photons which are 22.5 degree oriented, then 17 photons are passing. When we measure 20 photons which are 67.5 degree oriented, this time 3 photons are passing. We can experiment this at our home. These are linear polarized 3D glasses used to see 3D movies. Both side glasses are having opposite polarization to each other. One side is horizontal and another side is vertical. We need 3 glasses for our experiment. First one is vertical, second one is 45 degree tilted, and third one is horizontal. Let us place the vertical filter in front of the camera. See, the lights are darkening because 50% of the photons are absorbed by the filter. The photons which are passing through this filter are now having vertical polarization. Now let us place the horizontal filter in front of the vertical filter. Here we can see all photons are blocked because the photons and filter are having completely opposite polarization. Now we can see the quantum behavior. Place the 45 degree tilted filter in between the two filters. Surprisingly, we are able to see the lights. You know the reason, right? It is not happening if we place the 45 degree tilted filter before the first filter or after the second filter. 50% blocked lights are released if we place the 45 degree filter only between the two filters. No one knows under which criteria the nature selects photons to pass the filter.